Honor has decided to follow in parent company Huawei's footsteps and just kind of ignore the MWC cancellation and go ahead with announcing products anyway. Among those is the Western release of the MagicBook laptops that we saw come out in China late last year. I got the chance to take a look at one last week, so here are some thoughts. Okay, so Honor is releasing a MagicBook 14 and a MagicBook 15, which makes a lot of sense. They are very, very similar laptops. Internal specs are almost identical. Obviously, the 15 is a little bit bigger, a little bit heavier. It's about 0.2 kilos heavier. It's sort of 1.5 something, and the 14 is 1.3 something in terms of kilos. Otherwise, they are very similar looking. They have the same ports. You get USB-C, but also USB-A and HDMI, which is really nice. They're both HD, just 1920 by 1080 resolution. You'll note that means they're 16 by 9. As opposed to 3x2, which is the kind of boxier aspect ratio that Huawei prefers on its laptops. So if you don't like that, if you want the more widescreen look, you might actually prefer Honor to the Huawei's. There is one thing that these two laptops borrow from Huawei though, which is color scheme. They come in two colors. There's a space gray and a mystic silver. That is it. They don't have a nice fancy green color like the Huawei MateBook X Pro that we saw launched earlier today. But still, the silver and gray are nice. And Honor has added a little touch that makes them a bit more unique and a little bit more exciting than Huawei's take on the silver and grey. And that is in the blue chamfering that you will see around the edges of the laptop and also embossed into the Honor logo. So you get this nice sort of reflective blue finish. I think having it in the logo, I find a little bit garish, but the touches around the edge of the device are actually lovely. It looks really nice. You don't notice them too much. They're kind of subtle, but then you catch the light and you go, oh, what's that? What's going on at the edge of the laptop there? It looks really, really good. It looks better in person, I think, than maybe in some of the official press photography and that kind of thing. It's worth seeing and seeing how it catches light as you move around. It makes sense. I think Honor's had a good run of doing that kind of finish on their phones in like different reflective colored phone backs. So it's nice to see that approach come to the MagicBooks as well. What about specs? So one of the really interesting things is they've chosen to go with Ryzen over Intel. There is no Intel model of these, at least not in the West. So it's the Ryzen 5 3500U processor. That's the same in both sizes of the laptop. And that will come with 8 GB of RAM and either 256 or 512 gigabytes of storage. That's gonna depend a little bit on the market. Some markets may get a choice, I'm not sure, but basically look which one you get wherever you are. So those should actually be pretty solid specs, especially for what's basically a mid-range laptop. It's not gonna cost too much. And this should be powerful. If you haven't had a Ryzen processor in a laptop before, and it makes you a bit nervous because you're very used to things having an Intel and having a Core i something or other, don't be afraid. The reason Ryzen chips are in this and the reason they're in a lot of laptops right now is because AMD has really stepped its game up in terms of the laptop space and the desktop space, actually. But these processors are a lot better. They are much more competitive than they used to be, and you will not have any issues switching to a Ryzen chip. This will still be very fast and very powerful, and that is basically why Honor has decided to go with it. It is a great processor at this kind of price point. One oddity is battery. So, the laptop comes with 65 watt fast charging, which is really good. You will get a load of battery life back in just half an hour of charging. The weird thing is battery capacity. So you might think the bigger laptop would have a bigger battery because it has more space in the big laptop to fit a big battery. Honor does not see space or physics that way. Instead, it's put a 42 watt hour battery in the MagicBook 15, respectable, and a 56 watt hour battery in the 14. This is very odd. It means that the 14 should have great battery life. It should basically be all day. Honor is saying it can do 10 hours of uninterrupted use on most stuff, which is great. That's more than enough for most people. The 15 though has a sort of a quarter less battery capacity and it's got a bigger screen to power. So the 15 inch is definitely going to have worse battery life. I don't have a battery life figure on it right now to sort of compare, but I wouldn't be surprised if it's more like 7 hours or something like that. I cannot explain why this has happened. It does mean the 15 looks a little bit unattractive unless you really need that bigger screen size. But I imagine for most people that's gonna make the 14 much more compelling. It's gonna be lighter, it's gonna be more portable. 14 inches is still a really good laptop screen size, and you're gonna have that better battery life to boot. And the one final thing to note about the MagicBook is that it has borrowed some stuff from Huawei, which is nice to see. One is software stuff. So Huawei is making a big push on ecosystem at the moment. The idea that if you get one of its phones, it can work very nicely with its computers and with its new tablet and all that kind of stuff. And Honor is in that same ecosystem. So there's cross compatibility between Honor and Huawei products. So what that basically means in the case of the MagicBook is that if you take an Honor or a Huawei phone and place it on the little sticker at the bottom right of the laptop next to the trackpad, you can drag and drop files from the phone straight to the computer and vice versa. You can use the computer mouse and keyboard to control the phone. You can actually have the phone window appear as a, the phone screen appear as a kind of floating window on your desktop. All things like that. Really useful, really handy, and it's a good reason to look at an Honor laptop if you happen to already use an Honor phone, which is nice. The other thing they borrowed from Huawei, I like and I don't like. It's the camera hidden inside a key on the keyboard. So it's sitting in the function key row, you tap it and a camera pops up and then you push it back down again to put it away again. This means the bezels on the screen are thinner than they would be otherwise. They're still not quite as thin as you'll see on the high-end Huawei laptops, but there's pretty slim bezels, especially for this price point. But the downside is the angle on the camera is awful. It's going right up and catching underneath your jaw, and it looks horrible. No one looks good in this. It's very unflattering. If you're like me and you never actually really use that camera, this is great because it just frees up that screen real estate and gets the camera out of the way. On the other hand, if you know you're going to spend a lot of time on Skype calls or anything similar to that, or trying to stream video off yourself from the laptop, this is not the one. It's a bad camera angle. You won't like it. Get a laptop that has a camera in the top bezel if you're going to use it a lot. It's worth that little bit of extra bezel. But yeah, if you're like me, you don't need the camera, this is great. So yeah, that is the MagicBook 14 and 15. If you had to pick, I think the 14 looks like a clear winner from battery capacity. Otherwise, they're very, very similar. But they both look great, very similar to the refreshed MateBook D laptops that Huawei announced today for Europe as well. It's nice to see these actually coming to the West. These kind of products often haven't before. It's a sign that Honor and Huawei are still pushing ahead into the West despite all the US trade ban stuff. And that's really nice to see. Stay tuned to the channel, like, subscribe. We've got some other videos on all of today's Honor and Huawei announcements. And check out Fast Charge this Thursday, where me and some of the rest of the team will be talking about it all. Thanks.